I've trained more for this fight than any fight I've ever had combined. Steamer sauna will probably only take us an hour, maybe two. Because I want it to be really easy, so maybe 2 hours. But I'm fighting up a weight class from what I normally fight, and my diet has been on point this fight. So it's going to be really easy. I'm excited.
We're going to have a nice, easy weight cut this time. All right, last time. I know diet pills were involved this time. It's the prolonged effect this time. Last time he had a short camp where he went from like 180, got down to 165, then tried to get to 45. This time he's been walking around at 65, 66, going to 55. So for the last 3-4 months, his body's been ready to do this.
I'm ready to go sweat. Let's get it.
Do it.
That's with a bottle of water last night and a little bit of water this morning. He didn't say that, but I know he did drink some. Maybe take a couple minute break to see how he's feeling. But I think with how fast he's letting go of water, we're only gonna be an hour or two max, so.
Feels good, this is so easy. It doesn't usually get hard till like the fifth or sixth one. This one I could do this all day.
We'll see how he feels in about 20-30 minutes.
I'm on keto right now, so I thought I used to do keto right and I just was doing it wrong. So this fight camp, I've been in keto for, gosh, how many months would you say? Since I bought those key things from you. It's like 3 or 4 months I've been in keto and I've never felt faster, I've never felt stronger, I've never felt more conditioned. I feel like I'm smarter. This weight cut is easy. I can walk around at 165 pounds like that, which I've never been able to do. Like I've had to struggle and skip meals and do tons of fasted cardio, and I don't do any of that now, so I feel great.
We've done 2 rounds, we're gonna do one more and check our weight, that'll be right about an hour from when we started. Woo!
coach that prepares you for the cup. When you're prepared, listen, I got shorts that weigh half a pound right now.
Done.
I'm out. I'm gonna sit down for a second, and then I'm gone.
That was an easy hour cut too, man. We only spent about 30 minutes in the steam room total, so
yeah.
That's perfect.
A lot of people look down on this, and I even was scared to do it the first time I did it. But Lucas got coaching from Craig Pressendorf. We're gonna give you a shout out, Craig. The dude just knows the stuff. He had Lucas drink 2 gallons of water the day before he weighed in, which scares most people because I look at the scale so much. And when I drink 2 gallons of water before, the day before, I drop water 10 times faster. It's amazing. Works great.
That's down 10 pounds of water weight with only 30 minutes of sauna time.
I'm happy.
That's how it's done.
Shout out to Craig, dude. I made weight going from what Lucas taught me, 2 gallons of water the day before. Less than 30 minutes of sauna time, cut 10 pounds, baby.
So me and Thomas wanted to show something. We didn't take any pictures of my weight, but I weighed in at about 192 when we started. Didn't drink the whole time, the same hour. I did everything that he did. I only lost 2 pounds compared to his 5 pounds. That just shows you the difference of somebody who prepares their body to let go of the water and lose the weight, as opposed to someone like me who still eats clean, still not eating bad, but I didn't do the preparation to make my body let go of the water. One big mistake people make is they cut sodium out too early. When you cut sodium out a week or 2 weeks out, all of a sudden you're gonna start cramping, you're not gonna be feeling as good. We don't cut sodium out until the day before. So he ate normal all the way up until Tuesday. He ate a normal meal schedule. Tuesday night was his last meal. He cut sodium out, started drinking a bunch of water. That's what the water flush does. So he drank 2 gallons of water and took a couple hot Epsom salt baths while he was still drinking. That just pushes all that sodium out. It takes one day if you do it properly. And as you can see, 10 pounds like that.
It'll work, baby.
Get to go get this miserable part over with. Let him weigh in, eat, and drink.
Ready to get on, get it done.
Easy.
Did it.
Even 1 pound under.
A little bit of carbs make you happy. What a lot of people don't understand is that the weigh-in is the fight before the fight. So I've had countless people tell me, oh, I only got 10 pounds to lose. Well, if you don't mentally and physically prepare your body to lose that 10 pounds, it's gonna be a rough time. Or, I mean, that was still rough. As easy as it looked, dropping 10 pounds is not easy. But the fact that we were able to do it with 30 minutes in the steam room, a couple hot baths, you know, no severe dehydration is what you want to be like. So he mentally and physically prepared for the first fight. Now you're gonna see that pay off in the second fight, which is where you get to go have fun.
Easy, baby. Easy.
Steps to start, just rest, hydrate, eat, get some food in him. The refeed is super important too. Like a lot of people, They weigh in, they diet. Then they weigh in and they go carb load and eat all this crap. Thomas is gonna go eat bacon, eat some steak, eat some eggs. Still eating the same stuff that got him looking like he's looking right now. He just isn't gonna be it's not gonna be quite as tight. Tomorrow's the fun part. Thomas gets to go out there and do what he's been training for the last 6-7 months now. So he gets to get out and punch them in the face, get punched back. It's a pretty cool feeling.
My opponent didn't make weight. He missed it by like a pound and some. But I've been there before, and they came all the way down from Sacramento. They drove like 12 hours, and I'm cool with it, whatever. We accepted the fight anyway. A pound to me doesn't matter anyway, I don't care. I just wanted to see that he was willing to go and try, and he went and tried to make weight, so that's all I really cared about. So we're cool, both teams are good. It's time to fight, baby.
We touch them, then we kill them. Bang, bang.
Uppercut over.
Now it's the waiting game. We sit back here while everybody else gets to fight. The key is to kind of stay relaxed because it's obviously easy to get your adrenaline up, get pumping. So we're gonna stay relaxed, stay calm, move in, keep the blood pumping until it's time to really warm up. Once we warm up, we'll get a good sweat going. Hopefully time it perfectly, walk out, go do our thing.
I get so like, let's go.
All we gotta do is touch him. We're just gonna touch him. Touch him.
Hitler's gonna give me me.
A familiar face, training out of one hit MMA at 154.6 pounds, it is Thomas Hughes!
page from a magazine. Been looking for the answer ever since we were 17. You know the truth can be a weapon to fight this world of ill intentions. A new answer to the same question. How many times will you learn the same lesson? I think they got it all wrong. We just gotta hold on and on and on and on. 'Cause we're gonna be legends. Gonna get their attention. What we're doing here ain't just scary. It's about to be legendary. Souls we carry, and it's about to be legendary. This is what we came for, and we couldn't want it anymore. We could never turn back now. Got to leave it all on the floor. Been dreaming of the payoff through the struggles and the trade-offs. Fighting tooth and nail on the way up. Tell them the truth, but they think it's just made up. And I think they got it all wrong. We just gotta hold on. And on and on and on. 'Cause we're gonna be legends. Gonna get their attention. What we're doing here ain't just scary. It's about to be legendary. Yeah, we're gonna be legendary. Gonna teach them all the lessons. Got this feeling in our souls we carry. It's about to be legendary. Eventually they're gonna know who's right. To make a stand, you got to win the fight. Can't stand the heat and just the afterlife.
Official time of 2 minutes and 23 seconds. Your winner by knockout, Thomas Hughes! That was really precise fight. I mean, tell me, I mean, what are you doing to get that kind of precision?
Guys, I picture that happening in my head a million times before that happened. I work hard every day, I show up, and I do what my coaches tell me. We went over that 20 times in the back. We practiced it a million times, and that's exactly what happened because I saw it happen.
Beautiful. So we're envisioning it, makes it a reality. Well, let's move over to your, let's talk about your training camp, who you want to thank, if there's anybody who helped you get ready or anybody that's made this kind of career possible.
Yeah, best striking in the state, you guys, over at Eurasia, one hit MMA. I got a phenomenal jiu-jitsu coach, Lucas Montoya, over at Murray Academy. They helped me a lot with my ground game. I didn't have to use it, but hey, what the hell. I want to thank my sponsors, everybody that made this possible. Showed up every day, we worked hard, and we drilled over and over. Coach Kellen, love you, baby. I'm out.
Thomas Hughes!
It's supposed to meet you guys. You guys are awesome.
Oh, dude. Thomas is doing everything I said. And did you see, like, so Thomas hit him, hurt him, and he was here, and he had him hurt, and then he switched in, so wow, 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 wow.
Yeah. Hey.
He listened beautifully the whole time he was in there. He was doing what we were calling from the corner. He did what we trained before the fight. He was in shape, he was in condition, he was patient, which is huge for Thomas because he wants to kill people, right? So the fact that he was able to be a little bit patient, pick the shot. He hit him, switched stance, finished the fight. Night over, Thomas is going to the next level.